I firstly want to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we meet and pay my respects to their elders past and present. Thank you, Mike, for that very generous introduction and the very relevant linkages that you have made with respect to community broadcasting and community television in particular. You make some very salient points about the Broadcasting Services Act that's just clicked over 25 years. It's great to be here in Melbourne this fine evening, and thank you so much for so many people for turning out for what I think is an important discussion that we need to have. Thank you very much to Channel 31 for hosting me, for the advice of your General Manager Matt Field in conceiving it, for the hard work of the staff of Channel 31 and their dedicated team of young volunteers in setting everything up. I was once a young volunteer. Your efforts are sincerely appreciated, and thank you very much for being here. And thank you also to RMIT and those of you representing RMIT for hosting us here on campus tonight. For the benefit of those watching us on the live stream, RMITV is the student-run television production house here at RMIT. It has a long history of producers and practitioners moving into professional employment in the industry. The alumni of RMITV include Rove McManus, Peter Hellyer, Hamish and Andy, Merrick Watts and Tim Ross, Nazim Hussain, Waleed Ali, Shona Devlin and Tom Ballard, just to mention a few. A very impressive roll call. We found it extremely useful to have people like Mike and Matt Field to share ideas with, and that's why we're here. In Parliament, I have made representations on behalf of the sector to extend the licence period for community TV, and I think this action actually strengthens the case for community television. It strengthens it. At this point, now more than ever, Australians need strong and vibrant public broadcasters and community TV and radio broadcasters across platforms to ensure that diversity in our media voices. So now is indeed the time to reimagine the role of community television broadcasting. I look forward to hearing your questions, but most of all, your ideas. As Mike said, this is an important part of policy development. Labor is formulating its policies in this area. Community television is a vital policy that will be developed. The best way in order to have a relevant policy in this area is to consult and is to listen. That's the key reason why I'm here today, and I thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to do so. Thank you. Thank you.